Hi, this is Nikhil here.
And this is Mamta here.
Hope you all are safe at home. We are excited to present to you our very first tutorial, which is making better images using just natural light. Let's dive right in.
Let's begin by understanding light. For any light, there are three important features: its size, direction, and the intensity of the light. These decide the contrast in the image and the depth of the shadows. The most basic form of light is natural light, and that is any light created by the sun. Sunlight changes based on the time of the day, the weather, and your location. So let's show you how you can identify good light and use them in different situations.
Let's begin with direct sunlight. Like for example in this image, this type of light creates deep and harsh shadows. Keep an eye out for these shadows, since that's a great opportunity to create mood and drama in your images. A washed out image in the noon sun doesn't really look that great. So wait for the sun to be at an oblique angle and find a semi-shaded spot like in this photograph. Notice here how the sun is casting stark shadows. So move around and see how these shadows change from a different angle, and use the light and the dark play to create shapes in your compositions.
You can use direct sunlight to shoot your products as well. Like you can see in this image, a more creative way to use sunlight is when it is filtered through some material like a net, a translucent roof, a window or a grill, or even through leaves. It casts interesting shadows on your subject and makes the image more appealing. So an exercise that you can do is see how the sunlight is filtered through different items throughout the day and to shoot these interesting patterns.
Before we move ahead, quick reminder to follow us on Instagram, because that's where we put all of our images. Next up is diffused or ambient light. Overcast cloudy days give you some beautiful soft light with the clouds acting like a big natural diffuser. For example, look at this image and notice the shadows. If you're out in the open, you can position your subjects almost anywhere and the light would still look the same. Here's another happy couple. Such ambient light is great for portraits because you result in beautiful skin tones and you'll get fully detailed shadows and highlights. Don't worry if you don't find any clouds when you're shooting outside and you still want this kind of light. You can get it in the early mornings and in the evenings when the sun is not directly hitting on your scene.
Up next is how you can use natural light coming from your window. So during the day, when the sun is not directly falling in, the entire window acts like a rectangular source of light. And this is great for shooting food and products. So this image was shot using a window light on the right. A light coming from one direction usually gives dark contrasty shadows, but for this composition we wanted some softer shadows. We did this by placing a reflector on the left of the bottle to bounce back some of the light coming in. You don't need a fancy reflector, anything that is wide and big would do. You could try using a chart paper, a thermocol sheet, or even a plate, steel plate would do. So here are some more photographs that we made using only window light. Observe the various ways light hits a scene. Food and product photography has a lot to do with styling. Let us know if you would like to learn more about food and product styling so that we can talk about these in our later video.
Window light is great for shooting people as well. Here's a groom getting ready on the wedding day. Switching off the indoor lights and moving the subject closer to the window will give you more contrasty, deeper looking shadows. Curtains can be a great way to control the amount of light that is coming in and make your images look more dramatic. Here's an exercise for you guys. Shoot a subject at different distances from the window and see how the light falls differently on the same subject. It can be a person or simply a thing. You can also use sunlight falling in through the window like in this series of images. But remember that sunlight will always give you dark contrasty shadows.
So now to our favorite part, which is silhouettes. Silhouettes are created when you're shooting a subject against light. Like in this image, the subject appears darker and you don't see any details of your subject. This one shot, I've taken it from my mobile phone and it was shot directly against the sun. You can see the interesting patterns that the light is creating on the sand. Almost any subject can be made into a silhouette. Remember that the shape of the subject is identifiable and something distinct. Shooting against doors and windows can create interesting silhouette opportunities. Well, that's about it. Go and try something new. You don't need any fancy equipment. You don't need strobe lighting. You can just start off learning photography by understanding how natural light works. and shooting at different times of the day.
So the next time you're in any natural light situation, which is almost the entire day, see how you can use that in your composition to convey the mood, drama and the story that you want to say. Well, that's all from us today. If you've liked this video, give us a thumbs up. Let us know in the comments below what more you want to learn from us. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. And most importantly, stay home, stay safe, and help in the relief work in whatever way that you can.